Good evening, Rahul. Much as my good friend Tehsin would like you and others to believe, this is not happening in isolation. That is why you need to give me 2.5 minutes because I need to expose this whole agenda. Because the Congress has a history of acute Hindu phobia and Hindu mesia. Many of its leaders not only mock Yogi Adityanath wearing saffron, they deliberately call Yogi Adityanath as Ajay Bisht. Name that he renounced after he became a yogi in accordance with his mutt and the Nath sect. But they never call the evangelist Mother Teresa by her real name of Anjes Gonjes Bojahu, do they? And this is just the tip of the iceberg. That is why I want to expose them. Remember the statement by Congress leader Jharkhiholi that Hindu has a dirty meaning and Indians would be ashamed of it. And who did Rahul Gandhi meet, by the way, recently on his Bharat Jodo Yatra? Yes. The virulently anti-Hindu pastor George Punaiya, who told him Jesus is the real God, not Shakti. Then there is Shivraj Patil, who claimed Lord Krishna taught jihad to Arjuna in the Bhagavad Gita. Recall how Mahila Congress leader Lavanya Balal made a horrible Gaumutra jibe, same as the Pulwama bomber. And then an alleged post by the Congress youth wing leader Shaukat Ali called Hinduism a terrorist religion, quote unquote. Recently, a Goa Congress leader Jalmi termed Hindu god Parasuram a terrorist and a rapist. Congress mouthpiece National Herald routinely publishes Hindu-phobic articles, including one where it said Hindu epics were replete with misogyny and Me Too instances. Remember, Congress leaders and Congress party itself celebrates Tipu Jayanti, despite knowing he demolished hundreds of temples and converted and butchered lakhs of Hindus. And who can forget that the phrase saffron terror was coined by the Congress and that it wanted to pass the communal violence bill, where only the majority, that is Hindus, would be held guilty in a communal riot? Remember how the Congress blamed the Hindu RSS for 26/11 terror attack? Had Kasab not been caught alive, it is beyond doubt that the Congress would have fortified this theory. Then there was the Congress dispensation in 2004 that asked a Hindu Doordarshan anchor not to display his Hindu sacred symbol Kalava. Remember how Congress leaders publicly butchered a calf just to mock Hindu sensibilities in Kerala? Recall how time and again the Congress derides and insults and denigrates Hindutva, despite the fact that, quote, Hindutva means the Indian culture and not merely the Hindu religion, unquote. This was the famous conclusion of the Supreme Court back in 1995. And on the other hand, how many instances are there where the Congress has abused Islam or Islamic organizations? In fact, it demanded hanging of Kamlesh Tiwari for making a comment it considered Islamophobic, and its prominent leader fought against the banning of Simi. And remember how PM Manmohan Singh on the floor of our parliament demanded an apology from Denmark for profit cartoons? Remember how Sonia Gandhi apologized to the Shahi Imam for Jama Masjid for the same thing? So we have to look at this not in isolation, but in totality. And what do we see? Rampant and acute Hindu phobia by the Congress.
You forgot something, Dr. Ranganathan. Maybe Digvijay Singh embraced Zakir Naik because he also wore a suit and tie.
Well, and we know
that Zakir Naik is known for very radical and regressive views.
But those are not Zakir Naik's views. I don't need to go into that.
Well.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Qureshi Saab, thank you very much for allowing me 10 seconds. No, I listened to my good friend, Dr. Mishra.
Rahul, should I speak first?
Dr. Ranganathan ko 10 seconds de dijiye. Uske baad main aapke paas aa raha hu. Chand.
Thank you.
10 seconds. Yes.
Tick.
Thank you.
No issue. Thank you.
डॉक्टर कौशल मिश्रा की बात मैंने सुनी. उन्होंने कहा कि कांग्रेस के लोगों ने सैफरन टेरर वर्ड कॉइन किया. मैं इनसे दो सवाल पूछना चाहता हूं. दो लोगों ने सैफरन टेरर कॉइन किया था और एक आदमी ने कहा था कि आरएसएस वाज बिहाइंड द 26/11 अटैक. वो दोनों आज बीजेपी में हैं. आप उनके बारे में क्या कहना चाहेंगे?
नो एंड देयर इज नो डाउट अबाउट दैट. And the fact is now everyone in Congress has started wearing white t-shirts. So obviously clothes maketh a man. And the person, I don't know why Tehsin is not wearing a white t-shirt. He should be.